मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
ओके सो व्हाट वाज द लास्ट टॉपिक दैट वी वर सीइंग एंटनी? लास्ट टॉपिक
डेटाबेस कमांड्स इन एसक्यूएल।
डिफरेंट डिफरेंट
रोस
रोस No, Meghna.
Creating a table at the table.
Creating a table. So I have told you how to create a table. What is the syntax of creating a table? Create table, then the table name, open a parenthesis, and write the data type, column name, which data type, separated by comma, then close the bracket, semicolon. That is the syntax of creating a table, isn't it? So what are the different data types supported in SQL, Hannah? Different data types.
Numeric, date and time, then string types.
And how to insert the values into a table? With whom?
Varchar, varkar.
How to insert values into a table? For inserting values into a table, you need to use insert query, isn't it? Did I take it for you, Reina? Insert query.
Last class I was not there.
Wonderful. Vithul?
Ma'am, last class we have certainly insert record with specific column.
Okay. Selecting the records. All right. Anyways, let's see. How to insert values. So how to create table we have seen. Now let's see how to insert values. For inserting, so note down, for inserting, you need to use a DML query, insert. And the format is insert into table name values. Insert space into space table name space values. Insert into table name. So this is just an example. When you say general format, you have to write insert space into space the table name. So these are the compulsory things. Then values. And open a bracket again. And the corresponding values should be enter. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Four columns are there in this table. So you need to enter all the column values. All the date and the text data type values should be enclosed in quotes. Numbers should not be enclosed in quotes. That is why 1 and 34,000 is not enclosed in quotes. Rakesh and sales enclosed in quotes. This is the first method of inserting values into a table. There are two methods. This value, when you use this particular method, you have to enter values to all the columns. Compulsory. You can't skip any columns. If four columns are there, you have to insert values into four columns. If five columns are there, you have to insert values into five columns. Compulsory. But this is the simplest method. Is that clear? This is another example. Insert into student values one comma, Mahi comma, science comma, 89. So another example. That is the first method. Second method, if you want to select certain columns and if you want to enter the values only to certain columns, then you can use the second method. Second method is insert into EMP. Insert into table name. Till here it is same. Then there is a difference. Then you have to specify to which all columns you are planning to enter the values. So that column names, the original column names, you need to specify inside the brackets. EMPNO, name, comma, DPT. We can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. But I'm planning to enter only values to 3 columns. That is EMPNO, name, and DPT. Then close the bracket. Then you have to write the statement. The keyword values, then the corresponding values based on the order. The order should be maintained. EMPNO should be written first, name should be written second, DPT should be written as the third argument, then semicolon. Is that clear? Any doubt? Reina? Amalraj, Lydia, Elvina, Ancho, Adona, Anthony, Nevin, turn on your video.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, like we are giving the specified columns, like.
Yes, for specified columns.
Okay. In that we are entering that you told, no, the value name and all.
Yes. Just a moment. So now, Elvina, tell me, I want to insert a row into student with roll number, name, and mark. And the subject, I don't know. So how to write the course using the second method? So the values I need to enter is 1, 2 in the place of roll number. A name, Elvina. Not sure about the mark. Sorry, the subject. The mark is 90. So use the second method and tell me how to write.
Insert into insert into student bracket. Roll number, name, class mark.
Name and just mark, okay.
Mark and close bracket.
Okay.
Values. Values, bracket and two. Elvina. And any marks? 9.
Very good. This is how you need to write the statement. So specify the columns you want to enter into the table. And the column names should be same. Don't change the column names. The original column names, then specify the values. Clear? Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, let's see the select queries. Select queries, as you all know, select queries are used to retrieve the data. It is one of the DML commands, select. So, so write the heading as select query. Anthony, Nevin, turn on your video. Select. In order to retrieve the data from the database table, we use select queries. If you want to search for MP3 songs in your laptop or PC, what do you do, Anthony? want to search for MP3 songs. All the MP3 songs. Which is you download it. Yes. How you search? How will you search for that?
Downloads.
Not only in downloads, many places it is saved. So
music
or specifically MP3 files, then how will you search for that? Music can be any kind of file. So I want to you want to get only MP3 extension files. So I'm not searching for any music files, isn't it? I'll go to YouTube and I will watch it. I watch the song, isn't it? That's what I'm telling. Vithur, any idea? Or you want to search for DOCX files in your system? What will you do? Or PDF files? Vithur?
We will go to search.
Search. After that,
we will write. We will type the file name.
File name you don't know. Only the extension you know. Make now.
Search.
Search.
Then the extension name.
Simply extension is enough. To find out all the files. Dot MP3, but something else should be there. Simply dot MP3 will not give you the result. If you don't know, no, I will show you how to search for that.
APK.
No, not APK and all. What is the search button? Yes. Search this PC. All right. I just want to search for all PDF files inside this PC. So what I need to do is star. Star means everything. Dot PDF. Nothing is coming. Yes. No files. Then we'll select the PDF here. So it will give you all the PDF files which is available in D drive. All right. That same way you can search for star dot MP3. No items. There is no MP3 file. So this star is used to search for all the files. Star means everything. So why I told you this? Because if you want to view the entire content of the table, then you have to write a statement, select star from table name. Select star from table name. If you write in that way, what will happen? So what is the use of select query? Select star from student is used to display, retrieve all the information from student table. Clear? If you want to retrieve full information, entire table, then you have to use select star. If you want to use a specific column only, if you want to view, then you have to write select that particular column name. So only that column name will be displayed. If you want to view multiple column names, two column names, then you have to write. That is in the next. Select star from EMP means selecting all the details. Selecting desired column names, then you have to write select EMP and no comma name from EMP. So only two column values will be displayed. All right. So if you write in this way, it will give you a result. EMP and no name. Then the values. If you write in this way, the first thing is DEPT. DEPT, then name. The original table will not be having any change. Only the change in your view, only the display will be changed. That we'll see in the next class. Okay, it's time. Bye-bye.